context, family, sales, and the same day. It says, and the same day. That tells me that if what happens after verse 35 is on the same day, then there's something that took place before this time in the text.
Right.
When we go up ahead of verse 35, we come to understand that before we get to verse 35, Jesus is teaching his disciples.
Yes. All right.
Jesus is teaching the multitude.
All right.
And I made an observation to say to someone before we jump into this text that whenever God speaks a word to you, he ain't just speaking the word for you to shout. He ain't just speaking a word to you for you to get happy. He's speaking the word to you for you to apply it to your life. Am I right about it? Because I think it's just real ironic that the word that Jesus taught before verse 35 was very applicable when they got to verse 35. Yeah. Do you understand what I'm trying to tell you?
Yeah.
Before verse 35, Jesus told them that a sower went forth to sow seed.
Yeah.
He told them some fell by the wayside.
Yeah.
And the birds came and plucked it up before it had time to penetrate the soil. He said some fell in shallow earth and it sprung up.
Yeah.
Real quick, the sun scorched it and it dried and withered away. But then he said that some of it, well, it went down, but when it sprung up, it was choked out by the other weeds. And some fell on good ground. And when he gave interpretation of what that teaching meant, he said to his disciples privately about the ones that were choked, that they were choked out by the cares of this world. That they lost sight of the word that went forth. And the cares of this world made them lose sight of the word. And they were suffocated by the cares of this world. And isn't it ironic? Just a few verses later, here it is. The disciples are in the midst of the storm and the cares of the world. Made them forget all about the God who was on the boat. And the only reason why I'm telling you that, family, is you better be careful about the word that you hear. Because you are responsible for what you do with the word that you hear. Am I right about it? If the word of God says forgive, then you are responsible to forgive. I wonder how I'm going to win this on tonight. You gotta be careful with the word that you hear.
Yeah.
Because the word that you hear, God sent it. Can I tell you that you're not in here on accident?
Yeah.
You're in here on purpose. God has you here on purpose for you to hear the word that went forth on Wednesday and on Thursday. But the question is, what are you gonna do with the word that you receive? It's not enough. It's not enough to be in the house as the word goes forth. The question is, are you going to put that word into action?
Yeah.
So then the Bible says after teaching that Jesus has done his teaching, he sends the multitude away. And watch this. The Bible says, he says to his disciples, let us cross over to the other side. Bible says they took him even as he was into the ship. And the Bible says they got into the ship. But as they are traversing from one side of the Sea of Galilee to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, the Bible says a great storm of wind arose.
Yes.
A great storm. Meaning it was not the same old kind of storm that they've seen before. It was a great storm.
Yes.
It arose and it began to beat up on the ship.
Yes.
The Bible says the ship is tossed to and fro. So bad was this storm of wind that the Bible says that which was on the outside of the boat started to get on the inside of the boat. Don't you know you're in trouble when what's on the outside starts getting on the inside? Am I right about it? It's all right to be in trouble, but when the trouble gets on the inside, it's all right to be in painful and stressful situations, but oh, when the stress gets on the inside. So the Bible says it started to fill up. The boat starts to fill up with water. So much so until the disciples believe that they are going to die. Then they remember that Jesus was asleep on the boat. The Bible says they run to where Jesus is and they begin to wake him and cry to him and say, Master, do you not care that we are resurrection? Do you not care that we are about to die? The Bible says Jesus woke up, wiped the sleep out of his eyes, stood up and rose up. And the Bible says he looked at the wind and said, stop talking.
Yeah,
looked at the waves and said, be still.
Yeah.
In fact, the word that the Bible uses is he rebuked the wind.
Yeah.
He rebuked the waves. And the Bible says the waves and the wind and the rain, it all stopped.
All
but then
right.
The Bible says this, there was a great calm. Don't miss that, because when and so ever have you ever seen a rock hitting some water, and when the rock hits the water, there's a great ripple, but then that ripple lasts, don't it?
Yes.
Long after the rock hits the water. But the Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says that when he said, peace be still, there was a great calm. There was no ripple, there was no waves, but it just stopped. Am I right about it? The Bible says so great was this miracle that the disciples who had seen him cast out demons, the disciples who had seen him multiply fish and bread, the disciples who had heard these great teachings, they learned something else about Jesus. And they said, what manner of man is this?
My Lord.
That even the wind and the waves obey him. Can I just put the sermon on pause and take this in parentheses? You ain't seen nothing yet.
My Lord.
You ain't seen the waves that God can make. You ain't seen the waves and the bridges that God can do. You ain't seen nothing yet. Can I just encourage a believer for a moment? Hold on to God's unchanging hand.
Yeah.
I know you get tired every now and then, but hold on, family. Because you ain't seen nothing yet.
Yeah.
God is in the business of revealing himself in new ways.
Yeah. Yes, he is.
Hold on to God's unchanging
yeah.
hand.
Yeah.
I just need to tell you, based on this text, family, that you can survive the storms in your life.
Yeah.
Anybody got some storms in their life on tonight? Anybody ever been through the storm? The songwriter said, I've been through the storm and rain, but I made it.
Yeah.
Your hands are hard. Can we just give God some praise for the storms we've already been through, for the storms he's already brought us through? And if he brought you through the storm in the past, surely he'll bring you through again.
Yeah.
Anybody encouraged on tonight?
Yeah.
I'm coming through the storm.
Yeah.
You just high five your neighbor, check your neighbor. I'm coming through the storm. I'm coming through. I've been in the storm for a long time, but I'm coming through. I'm coming out of the storm.
Yeah.
I came in the storm to give God a mighty name. I came in the storm so God can give me the testimony.
Lord.
I'm in the storm.
My Lord.
But oh, praise God, I ain't going to stay in the storm.
Yeah. Yeah.
I ain't staying in the storm.
Oh.
All right, that's it. That's the rest of the sermon. I'm done. Is that one?
No.
Survive.
My Lord.
You can survive the storm.
Yeah.
Watch this, because this is going to bless you. If you're going to survive the storms of life, if you're taking notes, write this down. Watch this. You need to understand. Watch this. That unusual storms will arise in familiar places.
Yes. Yes. My Lord.
Unusual storms will arise in familiar places.
Yes.
The Sea of Galilee was a familiar place.
Yes.
The disciples understood these waters. They had traversed these waters before. They had experienced storms on these waters before. They were fishermen. They were sailors. But the text makes it clear that this storm was an unusual storm. Now, family, I just need to tell you this in the parentheses. Be careful in familiar places.
All right. All right.
Am I right about that? Have you ever been there in life?
Yeah.
Have you ever had a storm, an unusual storm, in some familiar places? I wasn't expecting a storm in my marriage, but I had some unusual storm in some familiar places. I wasn't expecting my children to get the problem, but I had some unusual storms and some familiar places. I've been in this church for 11 years, and I never thought I'd see a man like some familiar places. You can't ever get comfortable in life. Don't you ever take life for granted. Don't you ever think, I got this thing worked out. Lord, you just stay up there. I got this. I'm going to do this one by myself. No, sir, and no, ma'am, because life will present some unusual stones and some familiar places. Now, listen, family, because this is going to bless you, because I know that God can send stones in your life. Listen to me. Listen to me. I know that God can send stones and will send stones in your life. In fact, when you turn over to the book of Jonah, the Bible says it was God that literally hurled a great storm of wind. That's what it said, that God hurled it. But I'm struck by the language of this text, because when we get down to where Jesus, the Bible says, rebuked the great storm of wind, I'm struck by that, because it uses, listen to me, because this is going to bless you, the same words that Jesus used when he rebuked the demon-possessed man in Mark chapter 1 and verse 25. Did you hear me what I said? In Mark chapter 1, verse 25, Jesus uses the exact same words that he uses against this storm. He rebuked the demon and said, hold your peace. Here it is when he's speaking to this storm. The Bible says he rebukes the storm and says, hold your peace. The same words which gives me the suggestion that this storm didn't come from God. This was a storm that the devil sent trying to stop him from getting to the other side. You better hear me what I'm trying to tell you right now. Sometimes the enemy will send some things in your life. Why? Because he don't want you to make it to the other side. What I said, he don't want you to make it to the other side. You ain't listening to me. I'm gonna prove my point. Somebody say, prove it, preacher. Somebody say, prove it, preacher. Well, what was on the other side? On the other side was a demon-possessed man. On the other side was a man who was up in the mountains grinding and cutting himself. And the devil knew when Jesus showed up on the other side that something had to change in this man's life. And the devil didn't want to see change in his life.
My Lord.
You remember the story, don't you? The Bible says he cast the demon out the man. He's sitting clothed and in his right mind. Chapter 5, verse 18 says that. He says, can I go with you, Jesus? Jesus says, no, you just stay right here and tell everybody about what God did in your life. Wait a minute. Turn over to Mark chapter 8. And when you get to Mark chapter 8, they show back up to this place. But when they show back up, this one man has turned 10 cities all around. Lord, the devil is not going to show up on the other side. You be careful about giving up right now. Because God got a work for you on the other side. God got a mission for you on the other side. God got some souls to save on the other side. Don't give up now. Because all that can be on the other side. Tell somebody on the other side.
The other side. My Lord. My Lord.
There's work to do on the other side. Am I right about it? Sometimes he sends unusual storms. But you better be careful when you're going through unusual storms, because sometimes unusual storms are hiding an unusual move of God.
Yeah.
Ain't no way in the world one man ought to turn 10 cities upside down. But oh, when God is working in your life, when God is moving in your life, the devil didn't want them to show up on the other side.
Nope.
And I need to tell you that the devil don't want you to forgive. But forgive anyhow.
Yeah.
Am I right about it? The devil don't want you to let it go, but let it go anyhow. The devil don't want you to keep on working. He wants you to quit in the middle of the storm, but keep on holding on to God's unchanging hand.
My Lord.
I know it's an unusual storm. I know you ain't never been here before. I know you ain't ever seen nothing like this. But that just means you ain't ever seen nothing like what's going to happen.
Yeah, my Lord.
You're going to survive the storm. You need to understand.
My Lord.
Sometimes unusual storms arise in familiar places. Take your notes, write this down, because this is going to bless you. Watch this. Number two, you're going to survive the storms of life. Watch this. Not only do you need to understand that unusual storms will arise in familiar places, but watch this. You need to recognize your own human weakness.
All right. My Lord.
I'm going to tell you, I appreciate them, amen.
My Jesus, my Lord.
I appreciate them class and them shouts that y'all gave me on the first point. And I understand if you don't shout on this point, amen. Watch this. When storms arise in our lives, they have the tendency to expose our human weaknesses.
All right.
You hear what I said? Storms have the tendency to expose our human weakness. I'm just going to throw this in the parentheses. Now watch this. Isn't it powerful, though, that if you've ever been through a storm and it exposed your human weaknesses, now the blessing in that is that it ought to make you more understanding when dealing with other folks.
All right.
I didn't even intend to say that, but I just want to tell you that, right? You know you got weak when you was in the storm, so stop pointing your finger when other folks get weak in that storm. Am I right about it? Like you so such and much, like you all that, like you got Jesus' personal number, you got Jesus' people number, he called you personally, no sir and no ma'am. Everybody gets weak in that now.
Yeah.
Am I right about it? That's what happened to the disciples. That's what happened to the disciples. They were in the storm, and the storm revealed their human weakness.
Yeah.
Look, it revealed their physical weakness. Did you see that? They're rowing and rowing. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. But they could not row out of this storm.
Yeah.
You need to know, family, there are some storms. Your strength ain't going to get you out.
Yeah.
Your physical might ain't going to get you out. Boy, I don't care how good you look. Boy, I don't care how strong you is. There are some storms your physical body can't get you out of. Am I right about it? Not only were they physically weak, but they were mentally weak as well. The Bible said they were like, Lord, we are going to die. Have you ever been there in life?
Yeah.
Have you ever been there in life? God, listen to what I'm trying to tell you, family. I know that there are some folk who will tell you that if you can change the way you think, that you can change your life, like you got some kind of supernatural power all unto yourself. But can I tell you that all of your thinking ain't going to change anything if God don't want it to change? You are weak.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, I'm weak.
I'm weak.
I'm weak. I'm weak. I'm weak. Am I right about it? I know folks trying to tell you that you are a little God and you got something in your mind that can move mountains and you are a proud warrior Jesus. You can do all of those things, but can I tell you, sometimes we get mentally weak.
Yeah.
I want to tell you if I can think right, I can change my life, but the problem is I think wrong all too many times.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
They were not only physically weak and mentally weak, but watch this, family, they were spiritually weak.
Yeah.
Bible says they went to Jesus and said to Jesus, carest thou not that we perish? Have you ever been there in life? Come on, let's be honest. Listen, this is revival service, and revival 101 is you can't be revived until you admit where you come from.
Yeah.
Am I right about it? Have you ever been in a storm and were like, Lord, where you at?
Yeah.
Lord, I don't know why you're putting me through. Lord, it's too much for me to bear. The storm is too great for me. Have you ever been there? Surely you've been there. You want to know why? Because you're weak. With your weak self. Am I right about it? You tell your neighbor that. With your weak self. You are weak. You're weak. You're weak.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor I'm weak.
I'm weak.
I dare you to just confess that I'm weak.
I'm weak. Yeah, my Lord.
And I'm trying to tell you that the reason why I'm harping on this point like that is because it's time to reclaim Christianity. Did you hear what I said? We are weak. Am I right about that? I ain't no proud warrior. That ain't even in the Bible. I don't care who said it. That ain't even in the Bible. We don't pray without ceasing to show ourselves strong to the devil. We pray without ceasing to show ourselves weak to an almighty God. Ceasing to show ourselves strong to the devil. We pray without ceasing to show ourselves weak to an almighty God.
Yes, Lord.
But you know, proud warrior.
My Lord.
Yeah, praise just not at home. Come on, you are proud of. No, you weak with your weak self. I'm weak with my weak self.
My Lord.
You might be glad that you're weak.
Yeah.
Somebody, I dare you to say I'm weak.
I'm weak.
You want to know why? You want to explain that you're weak? Because Moses was weak.
Yeah.
Moses said, I stutter. But Jehovah God told Moses, don't worry about your weakness. Don't worry about your mouth. Because I'm going to be with your mouth. You just say what I want you to say. And he went down to Pharaoh and said, God said, let my people go. Here's what he said. He said, my strength is made perfect in your weakness. Hello, somebody. If God is going to show himself strong, show yourself strong on my behalf. I'm weak, God, and I need you. That's what grandmother said. I am weak.
Yeah.
With your weak self.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
show you one more thing. One more thing. If you're going to survive the storms of life, just let me tell you to trust Jesus in the midst of the storm. Am I right about it? Let me show you some unusual things. I know you read the text before, but let me show you some things in the text. The Bible says that he woke up. That they went and said, Master, carest thou not that we perish. Now, wait a minute. Don't read that too fast. Because the Bible says, after they came to him and said, Master, carest thou not that we perish. The Bible says he woke up. You missed that, didn't you? You missed that. Can I slow it down? Put that back on pause. Rewind and press play in slow motion. Watch this. The Bible says that when they said, Master, carest thou not that we perish, that he woke up. Now watch this, because this is going to bless you. The storm was raging, but Jesus was still sleeping. Do you understand what I'm saying? The wind was blowing, but Jesus was still asleep. The boat was tossing and turning, but Jesus was still asleep. But oh, when the disciples started praying, Jesus woke up. Am I right about it? Do you understand what I'm saying? He ain't wake up in the midst of the storm, because he ain't bothered by the storm. But oh, when the saints go to pray, there's something about the prayer of his saints that God will wake up. He'll come to attention. It ain't the storm that bothers God, but it's the saints. The Bible says he's writing your tears in the book. The Bible says weeping may endure for a night. Arose. Do you see that? Verse 37 says, and a great storm of wind arose. But then verse 39 says, and he, Jesus, arose. Do you see that? All I'm trying to tell you is that whatever the enemy is doing in your life, God can do greater. When the storm arose, Jesus arose. Am I right about it? When sickness comes in your body, don't you worry, don't you fret. Jesus will arise. Isn't that what we put our confidence in? If Jesus arises, he will work it out. Am I right about it? Just Sunday morning, we were celebrating the fact that Jesus arose. Am I right? And look, the Bible tells us, the psalmist tells us, because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know not who holds, not that my day is going to be all right, but I know who's holding the day. You understand? And because he arose, I got hope. And now watch what the Bible says. He rose up. He woke up. But then he spoke up. Do you see that? The Bible says he spoke to the wind. Family, it's not your speaking that moves mountains. It's the speaking of the Lord. Am I right about it? You can speak all day long, but if God don't will it to be so, it won't be so. But oh, when God speaks, mountains will move. When God speaks, ways will be made. I dare somebody now to humble yourself to God and say, speak, Lord. Speak to my marriage, God. Speak to my children. Because when God speaks, things have got to move. When God speaks, ways have got to be made. When God speaks, miracles will be performed. I dare somebody to say, speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. In my finances, speak. In my children's life, speak. In my ministry, speak. Speak in the name of Jesus. In my community. I was in that storm all that time, and you told me to keep going. But as soon as I get out of the storm, you tell me to pull over. Now, what is this about? Daddy turned around and said, baby, I want you to look back. Everyone that pulled over, they're still in the storm. But because you clap on the drive, you make it through the storm. And can I speak that to a weary believer tonight? It's all right to get tired. It's all right to get weak. It's all right to get faint. But family, keep on trying. Keep on going. Can I speak that to a young person tonight, baby? I know sometimes you feel like you are not enough. I know sometimes you feel like everybody else is better than you. But baby girl, can I just tell you, keep on going. Keep on swinging. Keep on running around the bases. Because after a while, by and by, you're going to make it through whatever storm you have. Did you hear me what I said? You just keep on holding on. After a while, by and by,
yes,
you're going to make it through the storm.
Yes,
no. Give God some grace.